बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर शगुफ्ता अंदली, प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन। आई एम हियर टू टीच यू द कोर्स ऑफ ज्योग्राफी एंड पेलियंटोलॉजी। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज एवोल्यूशन ऑफ कैमल। Camelopes is an extinct genus that lived in western North America. It ranged from Alaska to Mexico, from middle Pliocene to the end of Pleistocene. It shares a common ancestor with the Old World dromedary and Bactrian camel. Here are these three species of Camelopes: Camelopes concinus, hesternus, and Minidoka. Camelopes first appeared during Middle Pliocene, about 4 to 3.2 million years ago in southern North America, and became extinct at the end of Pleistocene. During Pleistocene warm periods, it inhabited Alaska and northern Yukon. These specimens date to around 50 to 45,000 years ago. During late Oligocene and early Miocene period, camels apparently underwent swift evolutionary change, resulting in several genera with different anatomical structures. They ranged from those with short limbs, those with gazelle-like bodies, and those with giraffe-like camels with long legs and long necks. This rich diversity decreased until a few species such as Camelopes hesternus remained in North America before going extinct entirely around 11,000 years ago. By the end of Pleistocene, with the extinction of Paracamelus and Titanotylopus, Camelopes was the only the camel remaining in North America and possibly both Americas. Camelopes extinction was part of a large North American extinction in which native horses, mastodons, and other camelids also died out. The complete mitochondrial genome of sequence of wild Bactrian camels indicate that the divergence time for Camelini and Lamini was estimated to be 25 million years. In the tribe Camelini, Bactrian camel and dromedary speciation may have begun 8 million years ago. In tribe Lamini, at first appears alpaca 10.4 million years ago, then vicuna species that began 6.4 million years ago, and then llama and guanaco diverged about 1.4 million years ago. Wild and domestic Bactrian camel have separate maternal origins, and that the two subspecies diverged some 0.7 million years ago. Domestic Bactrian camel originated from extant two-humped wild camel. Over 1000 years before century, Bactrian camels were reared in western China. Ancient Romans used to call two-humped camels as Bactrian camels. Within the subfamily Camelini, three species are recognized today based on International Commission on Zoological Nomenclature and Genomic Evidence. The Camelus dromedarius, which is domesticated. Camelus bactrianus, also domesticated. And Camelus ferus, two-humped wild species. One and two-humped camels diverged 4.4 million years ago. The split between the ancestors of wild and domestic Bactrian camels is more recent and was estimated at 1.1 million years ago. The New World Camelidae are smaller versions of the camels and live in the heights of mountains in South America. The modern camels tribe Camelinae and Laminae diverged one another about 17 million years ago. The Camelinae had reached Eurasia via the Bering Isthmus about 5 to 3 million years ago, whereas Laminae dispersed to South America via Panama's Isthmus about 3 million years ago. Camelus ferus was discovered in 1878. Nowadays, their range has become severely reduced to only 4 locations worldwide, 3 in China and 1 in Mongolia. These are now the last refuges of the wild camels, which are listed as critically endangered, as estimates for the numbers of the remaining animals range from only 1000 to 1600. They are double humped and even-toed ungulates, native to steppes of Central Asia. They have long, narrow, slit-like nostrils, a double row of long, thick eyelashes, and ears with hairs to provide protection against desert sandstorms. It is slightly smaller than domestic Bactrian camel and has been described as lithe and slender-legged, with very narrow feet and a body that looks laterally compressed. The humps are smaller, lower, and more conical in shape than those of the domestic Bactrian camel. These humps may often be about half the size of those of a domestic Bactrian camel. It has a flatter skull and a different shape of foot. The wool is sandy colored, shorter and sparser than that of domestic camel. It can also survive on water saltier than seawater, something which probably no other mammal in the world, including the domestic Bactrian camel, can tolerate. Bactrian camels are distributed mainly in Central Asian countries, including Mongolia, China, Kazakhstan, northeastern Afghanistan, Russia, Crimea, and Uzbekistan. A few populations can also be found in Pakistan, Iran, Turkey, and India. China harbors the largest number of domestic Bactrian camels, which are located mainly in Inner Mongolia, Xinjiang, Qinghai, and Gansu. Phylogeographic analysis of modern Bactrian camels from Mongolia, Russia, Crimea, Kazakhstan, Iran, and China revealed shared mitochondrial haplotypes as well as genome-wide gene flow across countries. The Bactrian or two-humped camels exist in cold deserts and dry steppes of Asia. The two-humped camel was domesticated on the border of Iran, Turkmenistan, and spread to an area bordered by southern Siberia, Mongolia, and China. It is generally believed that modern one-humped dromedary evolved from the two-humped Bactrian species, which likely developed the way it did as a result of Arctic climate, with its thick coat that can withstand temperature of minus 20 degrees Fahrenheit and that falls away when temperatures reach 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Around 2 million years ago, the Bactrian, looking very similar to the modern Bactrian, standing about 7 feet tall and weighing an average of 1800 pounds had evolved from Procamelus or perhaps the Paracamelus camelids that had traveled across the Bering Strait into the Arctic regions of Asia. Titanotylopus is an extinct genus. It was terrestrial herbivore endemic to North America from the late Miocene to Pleistocene. It was extremely large in size and likely developed to acclimate to the cold climate. It possessed long, massive limbs, a comparatively small brain case, and a convex slope between the eyes. Its average height was 3.5 meters. Like modern camels, it possessed a hump for fat storage. Its distinguishing characteristic is the large upper canines. Here are the two species of Titanotylopus, Nebrascensis and Spatulus. Camelus dromedarius is the most important livestock animal in the semi-arid areas of northern and eastern Africa as well as in Arabian Peninsula and Iran. The one-humped camel was domesticated about 3000 BCE in southern Arabia, mainly for its meat, milk, and transport. They account for approximately 90% of all the camels in the modern world. Some of the evidence state that modern dromedary camels, fetus, during prenatal development have two humps and also a vestigial hind hump in adult dromedaries. Given this evidence, it has been speculated that modern dromedaries evolved in the hotter, drier climates in Western Asia. Given this evolutionary evidence, it is also likely that the ancestors of the modern dromedary camel traveled to Middle Eastern and North African region. The wild dromedary would eventually become extinct in Middle East and only domesticated would survive. They had long hairs on their throat, shoulders, and humps. The coat is generally a shade of brown. Hump was 20 cm tall or more and is made up of fat bound together with fibrous tissue. They are active during daylight hours. They form herds of 20 individuals, which are led by a dominant male. They feed on foliage and desert vegetation. Several adaptations, such as ability to tolerate losing more than 30% of its total water content, allow it to thrive in its desert habitat. Now the family Laminae, the genus Guanaco, and the species Lama Guanaco. It is a camelid native to South America and closely related to llama. It stands between 1 and 1.3 meter at the shoulder, body length of 2.1 to 2.2 meter and weighs 90 to 140 kg. Its color varies little, ranging from a light brown to dark cinnamon and shading to white underneath. They have gray faces and small straight ears. It is one of the largest terrestrial mammal native to today's South America. This protects its neck from the predator attacks. Bolivians use the neck skin of these animals to make shoes. They inhabit the steppes, scrublands, and mountainous regions of South America. They are found in Peru, Bolivia, Chile, Argentina, and in Patagonia with a small population in Paraguay. A small introduced population exists on Starks Island and Falkland Islands with a population of around 400. This is the image of guanaco and a fossilized skull. Lama glama is domesticated South American camelid. It is very social animal and live with others as herd. Its wool is very soft. It can learn simple tasks after a few repetitions. The name llama, in the past also spelled llama or glama, was adopted by European settlers from native Peruvians. It appeared to have originated from central plains of North America about 40 million years ago. It migrated to South America about during the Great American Interchange. By the end of the last ice age, camelids were extinct in North America. As of 2007, there were over 7 million llamas and alpacas in South America, and due to importation from South America in the late 20th century, there are now over 158,000 llamas and 100,000 alpacas in US and Canada. Vicuna or Vicugna vicugna is a genus containing two wild South American camelids which live in the high alpine areas of Andes. This map is showing its distribution. It produces small amounts of extremely fine, long, woolly coat, which is tawny brown on the back, whereas the hair on the throat and chest is white and quite long. The head is slightly shorter than the guanacos, and the ears are slightly longer. The length of head and body ranges from 1.45 to 1.6 meter. The shoulder height is from 75 to 85 centimeter. Its weight is from 35 to 65 kg. Here are the species: Vicugna, 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 Vicugna mensalis. Alpaca or Vicugna pacos, it is noticeably smaller than llamas. The two animals are closely related and can successfully crossbreed. Alpacas and llamas are related to the guanaco. Alpacas are kept in herd that graze on the level heights of Andes of southern Peru, western Bolivia, Ecuador, and northern Chile at an altitude of 3,500 meters above sea level. Its fiber is used for making knitted and woven items similar to sheep's wool, that is blanket, sweaters, hats, gloves, scarves, socks, coats, and bedding in South America and other parts of the world. The fiber comes in more than 52 natural colors as classified in Peru, 12 in Australia, and 16 in United States. There are two breeds of alpaca, Suri alpaca and Huacaya alpaca. This diagrammatic presentation is summary of the evolution of camel. You can see gradual increase in length of the limbs, reduction in toes, increase in height of the crown, and enlargement of the skull from primitive to recent one. And now these are some references. Dear students, this was about the evolution of camels. I believe you have gone through it. Thank you so much.